Plaza Stadium. It is the second of three games in this Suho's Women's FAS, beg your pardon, Women's Tri Nation Series 2022. Well, if when present at the stadium just a couple of days back, of course, Singapore defeated Seychelles 6-2, and today, well, Seychelles will be playing Papua New Guinea, who are the home side today. And well, I'm sure that will be a great match. You can see they are very excited to be here. Their first set of the two matches. Papua New Guinea's young women raring to go. And just under 10 minutes, where we will have kickoff here at the Jalan Besar Stadium. And well, the likes of course, New Guinea, they should be much better than their men's national team, actually, in the world rankings. They are ranked 49 in the women's rankings out of 170. They did play Singapore back on the 6th of March. That was way back in 2015. And then in a goalless draw as well. This is the Seychelles side. And well, they'll be very excited as well to against Papua New Guinea. They did well in the first game. The result, well, not a reflection of how they played. It was particular lady by the name of Natasha Bibi who scored a brace for her country, and that second goal, I can tell you, was an excellent goal from outside, probably the best of the 8 goals of the night. It was well, a great shot from outside box and on the top corner. Of course, fans are coming here to support the ladies. Well, there was, of course, 1,500 fans on game against Seychelles for Singapore. But you still can get tickets, of course, coming on for the final match. It'll be on Monday. 4,000 spectators allowed in this stadium. And really a face there for the Singapore Singaporeans. It is head coach Annalene Chua. She was a former FAS employee in the grassroots and women's department as well. As the players get ready to come out
and kick off the proceedings in just under 5 minutes.
About 6-2, but I think she was very proud of her side as well, how they took on the opponents. She was a former lioness herself as well, 32 international caps in one goal for Singapore. Against Mongolia back in 2018, but she is leading her side today. So the Papua New Guinea side come out and get ready to take on the opponents. Seychelles there put on a great performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Seychelles. Standing for national anthem of Papua New Guinea.
Seychelles.
Let's hear it for Seychelles and Papua New Guinea.
The FAS Women's Tri Nations Series of 2022, the second of three matches. Remember, you can still come down and get tickets for this match. The big match on Monday sees Singapore playing Papua New Guinea. About to start in just under 10 seconds. Papua New Guinea in the yellow strip from the left to the right of your screens. Against Seychelles in the red strip. Playing at the Jalan Besar Stadium. As I mentioned earlier as well, Papua New Guinea, well, they are ranked higher than the men's team overall in their individual rankings. And, well, good lively start, but Avril Ellight just not taking any risks at that point. To just kick the ball out. Misunderstanding between the two players, and will be Guneba who puts that cross in, but Avril Ellight getting the ball straight into her face. She went down. must have hurt. She's up on her feet though. Good line beam. Starcher, a bit of pace down the left hand side. Good ball in as well. Is this going to be the opening goal? And, well, the ball is just bouncing around, but it was a good effort from Vina Murray. It's a lovely ball in as well from the Marie Kaipu. Did well to take it. A good first touch there. The chest, but just couldn't find the finishing. Not a good start for Avril Ally. Gossi here. In the corner. The second corner of the game, and Papua New Guinea off to a very, very good start, putting on a lot of pressure. Seychelles just have to find their footing. Gabong, the captain, with the corner, just goes across goal and it's lobbed, but it's palmed away. Did fall for Gossi, but she could not latch on to that. It, bit of an uneven bounce. She is again. Oh, they can finally catch their breaths now. Seychelles, having soaked up, well, quite a lot of pressure in the first 3 minutes as well. Lob, she, well, decided not to hold on to it, and it was an interesting decision, just palming it away. Fell to Gossi, who just couldn't get a foot of that ball. Just well to hold it up, Natasha Bibi. They'll be counting on her, they'll be looking to get the ball to her as much as they can today. And Papua New Guinea now is offside. Ever so slightly there. It was a very, very tight call. Well, given away cheaply. And Papua New Guinea come in Seychelles once again, but they do well to win it back and try to push up. Get more bodies in the Papua New Guinea's half. Only to now soak pressure again. Good interception that time from Rina Esther. Papa. The run forward here. Got three bodies. Well, there were a couple of players in an offside position, so she decided to just hold on to the ball a bit more. To time their runs to perfection. Was the youngest player starting today is Sasso Gossi, who's 18 years of age. It's for Papua New Guinea. Seychelles, I mentioned earlier as well, Rina Esther, only 16 years of age. Chances as well, they failed to capitalize and take them. They could have got a couple of goals up, Seychelles haven't really found their footing. Good 1-2. Is that too much? Rossi's got to chase that down, but she can't. Will be a throw in to Seychelles. Well, we did see 8 goals in the last match between Seychelles and Singapore, and I'm sure we'll see a few here today as well. Well, Tunnel Boy missing that in this. Shy to take a shot from distance. Gunimba gets a deflection and a corner for that as well. It's played into the box. It's cleared away. Guinea will come again at them. Mustache plays it forward here. Looks slightly promising now. Little 1-2. This is a good chance for Seychelles if they can get more bodies into the box. Looking for support, finds Ali. Was looking for options as Papua New Guinea now come forward and once again find themselves in an offside position. She might have been just played onside actually. Who was at the bottom of your screens there. That was a very, very tight decision. Tackle comes in, but it's another good tackle once again. Much on that, she's not chasing that down. Rossi just decided to let that run out of play. Times at Seychelles. Here are the voice of Angeline Chua, former lioness, giving instructions from the side. There's a moustache there who was well intercepted that time from Gabon. Good ball down the left-hand side, but it's offside once again. They are playing quite a high line, Seychelles. Change the tactics a bit. Angeline Chua obviously taking them to play a high line. They were playing a bit deep initially in the first 5 minutes of play, and well, they did end up absorbing a lot of pressure. They pushed up a little bit and playing a slightly higher line. It's maybe worked for them. Oh, a little slip there. Unfortunate. Baku. It's a decent cross in. Couldn't find a yellow shirt at that point. once again, and it's Lucy Mino who chases that down, but will be a throw into Seychelles. Sino make a couple of runs down that right-hand side. We're going to see a goal pretty soon. Early spread, couldn't deliver perfect ball that time. Looking for Jinnaboy. Gossi now. It's cut back. Awesome. Line cross. Goes for goal, but it's straight into the arms of Alvina Marie. It's Mandy Gabriel who played the opening game against. It's not a bad attempt from distance from the captain, Yvonne Gabon. Stole the ball away. Might have just got a slight deflection, but calmly taken by Alvina Murray. Well, the ball was kept in, and I think Rina Esther would have thought that ball rolled out and it was going to be a throw-in, but well, she's handled it. There you go. It did go out. Fair point to her. The Papua New Guinea now win a free kick, and well, it's played to the side netting. I was mentioning Vina Marie, the goalkeeper, in for Andy Gabriel, who conceded 6 goals in the hour opening game against Singapore. She's been given a rest. So quarter of an hour is coming up in this FAS Women's Tri-Nation Series 2022. Once again, cuts it back across, and this is a good chance, and what an important block that was. I think that might have been going in. Well, seen Gabon, the captain, try from distance a number of times, this time on the left foot. Face here going out. We'll take a closer look at exactly what happened. Just going in for the challenge and getting an elbow to the shoulder, but seen Gabong not shy to attempt from distance. Just having a bit of time to give the team some instructions. Maria Boniface just getting a little ice pack on the hit, an elbow just now. Shells. They've had quite a number of international matches as well recently. Papua New Guinea come once again, and it's Robin, that's way wide. last match, of course, against Singapore was a 6-2 loss. Lost 2-0. Against Saudi Arabia, that was a very historic match because of the... was Saudi's women's first international match ever. They have the honor of, you could say, playing against them, but not losing against them. So they did defeat Maldives, 4-0 win. That was early in the year as well, in February 2022. That was after they did lose to them 3 days prior to that. That's a ball cross, but it's met nicely. So we have picked up 3 losses and a win over the span of the last couple of months, Seychelles. Played 2 matches as well last year. Both against UAE, 4-1 and a 4-0 loss in September last year. So just that one win against Maldives, that 4-0 win after going down 1-0 to them 3 days prior. Looking to get a result here as well, or at least gain some experience. Opposition's half, Seychelles. Antoine Chua, you can hear her from my commentary position where shouting out instructions to get a team to push up more. Started off a little deep and playing a slightly higher line now. Did catch Papua New Guinea offside a couple of times, so it has worked. Sprayed too far forward. Paul Richards there to catch on to that. Papua New Guinea now start from the back. Haven't really seen much of Dasha Bibi. She's been a bit quiet. Singapore, 2 goals, one fantastic goal from outside the box, giving Singapore's goalkeeper Beatrice Tan no chance whatsoever. Singapore did pick up 2 goals in injury time as well. Perturbed, maybe frustrated with the team. It's a great ball in, and this is the opening goal. No. Once again, flag was raised. Once again, Papua New Guinea caught offside. A couple of body lengths side here. She's been present as well in front, Megan Gunimba, together with Yvonne Gabon. Catch their breath. It's been quite a decently high octane match, to say the least. Players having playing the humidity of Singapore. She might be slightly happy with the way her team has played. Nicola Levain. I'd like to see her go, her team maybe pick up a couple of goals early on. And a number of opportunities as well. Just didn't find the back of the net. It's a high boot. Should see a goal. So far, as I mentioned earlier, Anga Bonga, great to shoot from distance. Rossi as well, who's made some decent runs down that right hand side, the number seven. From Seychelles. Guinea look pretty disciplined at the back and well composed as well. Oh, it's a good run. Playing across. Oh, what a great interception that time. But fortunately, well, to Papua New Guinea, who have won the lead. Take a closer look here. Good on the left hand side. Just well, it took a deflection and it's an own goal. Very unfortunate for Seychelles and they'll be very disappointed. It did come off Mitchell Adu, the number 8. Just took a deflection and, well, fortunately, Seychelles find themselves one goal down after 25 minutes in a very unfortunate circumstances. Looking to come forward, a good run that time.
And Seychelles
maybe just should have played the ball earlier. Dasha Bibi that time, haven't really seen much of her. Good run from her, they've got to get the ball more to her. She's the one to make the difference for Seychelles. The left hand side, Maino with a ball spread across. Once again, the flag is raised for offside. It was also quite a tight call. it's much better Papua New Guinea. Highline is working for Seychelles. It's good tactics employed by Tonin Chua. Knows they can't play too deep, will be soaking up too much pressure from the opposition. New Guinea, well, just have to time these runs. Time while he's onside. Gabon. She was going to go for goal, and this is cross, and this should be the second goal. And yes, it is. Papua New Guinea get the second goal after 28 minutes. And well, they'll be really happy with that. Good play, clear across, and it was a really good cross as well. Just playing the ball perfectly across.
Ladies and gentlemen, goal scorer for Papua New Guinea, number 9, Mary Kaibu.
Mary Kaibu, the forward, winning the second goal. It's confirmation of the score. Well, after holding Papua New Guinea off for the first 25 minutes, it was a very unfortunate goal that they conceded. Themselves 2-0 down now. They can score goals. Four against Maldives, as I mentioned earlier. Two against Singapore just a couple of days back. Now this is going to be the third goal. Does well to hold up play, and well, just goes wide. Mary Kaipu, can't blame her for being selfish there. She had a iron goal. It's good first touch, and then as well to cut back the ball and lay it onto a stronger foot. It's a good run as well. Imba was just waiting for it, asking for it. You can see that. A little frustrated, but well, credit to Marie Kaipu, who did all the hard work. Seychelles just have to find a way back here. Just maybe hold possession and really dominated it. That's back of the game so far. Haven't had a shot at goal either. Papua New Guinea been a dominant force in this match after 31 minutes. Tasha Bibi through. Tasha Bibi, the experienced 37-year-old. Spearhead a team forward, lift their spirits. exploited the right side quite a bit, Papua New Guinea. And it's a great ball in. It's onside as well. Well, the flag was finally raised. It's quite late. She's got a spring in a step now. Mary Kaipu scoring the second goal. Seychelles have to find a way back here. Pull one back and just get themselves back in the game. It's good movement. Looking for Natasha Bibi once again. That's a lovely ball and great read by Davina Murray, who came out. Fortunately, she has a clash with Vatican. She committed cells in both of them. Ouch, that must definitely hurt. So heads clashing, but she read it well and she came out. Head injury, of course, checked is something that is taken very seriously. Head injuries in football must have hurt as well. Just get her bearings right before she comes back on. Just to recap the score, it is 2-0 to Papua New Guinea. Lone goal by Rachel Duke on 25 minutes. Fortunate goal that opened up the scoring for Papua New Guinea. Then it was Mary Kaipu who got the second goal for Papua New Guinea. Has them 2 goals to the good. Tasha Bibi to spray that to no man's land, but well read that time by Fred. They get the throw in and catch the breaths as well. As we've got about just under 10 minutes left to play in the first half. Shells absorbing a lot of pressure in the early part. They then decided to push up a little bit and play a higher line. Papua New Guinea getting caught offside numerous times, but nonetheless they're leading 2-0 here at the Jalan Besar Stadium. This FAS Women's Tri-Nation Series, second of the 3 matches. Of course, Singapore plays Papua New Guinea, so remember you can come down on Monday. Final of the 3 matches to catch that controlling encounter. Be a tough fight, I'm sure, for both sides. It's a good ball through. It's just going to be the 3rd goal. Just maybe. Just did a bit too wide, couldn't name up. Quick to react. straight, so it'll be a goal kick now. As I say, Monday we'll see Papua New Guinea playing Singapore. And I'm sure the fans will come flocking down. 1,005 in the first game. Of a possible 4,000 tickets. It's the first time the women's playing in front of fans, so do come down and support Singapore side. Or even Papua New Guinea. If you're neutral. Seychelles maybe just pick one to lock back just before the interval. Got a chance now, they've got a free kick. Got to get bodies into the box now. She's been lively force as well. You see Maino down the right hand side for Papua New Guinea. Made a couple of runs there. Back to defend as well, and Esther with a decent ball in, and this is a good chance, but a little bit out of reach for the captain, Mescalina. Maybe could have a few more goals. Seychelles found themselves unlucky as well to concede that goal. Did well not to hold up, but now they come again forward. Defended well at times. Tasha Bibi, beg your pardon, it was Misha Watikan, who's done well at the back. She's read of the opposition quite well. She's got pace on her as well. Did well to cut that off. Longer bomb. Well, it's clashing there. Two bodies gone down. But Seychelles here on the break. Can they get bodies up quickly here? Support. They've got two bodies up wide here, and this is a good chance. Pascalina could not get round. John Uti. Flag will be raised once again. Caught offside by the high line of Seychelles. Side. It's hard to tell from here. Once again, the Seychelles players have gone down, rushing for water. Most of the players is Hubert Knight. It's hard fought football play between the two sides. Thank you. captain now, and see, he goes once again. Mitchell could do that. Hanging up for Papua New Guinea. Good pressing from Tasha Bibi. The header. Wins the ball again here. It's good play from Gossi. Determined, and Gabo should finish this off. Yes, she does. Nice and easy. And that's good. Papua New Guinea 3-0 up after 43 minutes. And
ladies and gentlemen, goal for Papua New Guinea, scored by team captain number 6, Yvonne Gabon.
After that, just confirmation of the goal scorer. Bossy, just good first touch, and easily placed it at the back of the net for Papua New Guinea's third, and Seychelles will be highly disappointed. Being conceded just before going into the interval. Well, that's a confirmation. Yvonne Gabon for the third goal in 44 minutes.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there'll be
we're going to see another goal here just before half time. And well, looking for options. What a great interception that time. Cutting off Uri Kaiku, who was a goal scorer. But tell you what, Duncan has been a lively figure at the back. It's confirmation of a minute of injury time. Once again, what an important foot that just got in the way of Kaipu. We just won too many touches from her as well. They do win a corner. It'll be the last attempt at goal before the interval. It swung in and just goes wide. It'll be another corner. It's wrong. That might be the last attempt, but they do get another corner. And well, it is the halftime whistle here at the Jalan Besar Stadium, and we've had an entertaining first half to this.
And it's halftime.
We have scored the tri-nation series. Just to recap the goal scorers. Seychelles did well to fend Papua New Guinea off for the first 25 minutes, but it was Rachel Cadieux's own goal that put them one goal up for Papua New Guinea before Merikaipu got the second, and then he went on Gabon with the third just before halftime on 44 minutes, and we'll take a break and back in about 15 minutes for the controlling second half. Thank you.
Thank you. pass, she'll say my name. Ladies are your man. The club is full of ballers and the cup is full of girls. And now you fellas leave your women and friends. Cause it's 11:30 and the club is jumping, jumping.
Half-time substitution for Papua New Guinea, number 7, Sasio Rossi is replaced by number 16, Segude Izale. Number 3, Marius Joseph is replaced by Lavina Mola. Substitution for Seychelles, number 3, Errol Ellie is replaced by number 6, Samira Florentine.
Seychelles having a substitution. It will be Avril Ely who comes off. In her place coming in will be Samira Florentine. So, second half on the way here with Papua New Guinea leading 3-0. Just joined us to recap the goal scorers. It is Rachel Kadu. His own goal put Papua New Guinea in front after just 25 minutes. And then we did see Murray Kaipu get the second goal just 5 minutes later for Papua New Guinea. And then just before half time, Yvonne Gabong, the captain, picking up a goal in the 44th minute. New Guinea straight off the blocks here looking for the fourth goal. Mari Kapu, she's one to look out for. Singapore will be keeping an eye on her. She's had a few chances as well. She's got a bit of pace on her and she's good control of the ball. Seychelles are just maybe trying to get themselves back in this game. One back and just give them a bit of encouragement. Remember they did lose 6-2 to Singapore. Themselves 3-0 down now. Continuing a corner. Ready to Anthony Chua, who, well, technically made them play a high line and caught Papua New Guinea offside numerous times. Mm-hmm. her own balls. Tasha Bibi. Papua New Guinea look a very organized side. Some good players as well, some standout. Kaipu. Nabok as well, the captain. Afraid to try from distance. We saw her attempt a couple of shots from afar. Well, they're playing it across now. Yeah, substitute Vina Hola. First touch of the ball, but didn't produce the goods. Remember, Papua New Guinea playing Singapore, so do come down on Monday night. It's 8:30 kickoff for the third match of this Tri-Nation series. To play it on either side, decided to go for goal. Displeasure from her teammates. And she had the Kaipu coming down the left hand side as well, but the screens in. This back was to her, so decided to go for goal. Well, giving away. She's trying to put that through ball in. Immediately, Papua New Guinea win the ball back. Situation, you're pressing once again from that 37-year-old Natasha Bibi. Hasn't seen much of the ball tonight as she did against Singapore. Shells. It's come here to get experience, of course. It's all a learning experience for all the teams. Well, this is a good opportunity. That takes a goal. Catches a strike and it is a goal. It's a 4-4 for Papua New Guinea. And, well, out of nothing really. That lady, Mary Kaifu, gets on the score sheet once again for a second of the night. And the 4-4 Papua New Guinea.
Goal for Papua New Guinea. Scored by number 9, Marie Kaifu.
Everyone in the tracks, and well, no chance for Alvina Marie there. Lovely strike, lovely finish, lovely goal. So 4-0 confirmation on 52 minutes sees Mary Kaifu get her second of the night, and Papua New Guinea's fourth. Sure, we will see more goals coming in. Well, what are Seychelles going to do? Anthony Chouar has to find the answers. Slightly deeper than they did in the first half. Pushing up a bit more now. Tight legs will eventually get them. Change of boots now. It's Alicia. Solo boot coming off. Tackle in. Matika, she's done well in the first half as well. She's not afraid to put in those hard tackles, and she's a couple of good interceptions as well. But there's a bit of discussion going here on here to see who's going to line up to take this. Gabon, raring to go. Morris as well standing in the back, and well, there was a few tricks up there, and eventually Neba ended up striking the ball. Neba once again takes another shot, and it trickles into the back of the net, as Seychelles will be very disappointed with that, but it is the fifth goal. In the last 10 minutes for Papua New Guinea. This time, well, 12 to forward, Megan Kanemba, who goes in time and time again, striking distance.
Number 12, Megan Kanemba.
Well, might have just lost sight of the ball. Crowd of defenders then. Well, she saw that very late. She's highly frustrated with herself there, but it is Megan Kanemba who puts Papua New Guinea 5-0 up and her first goal of the night. There you go, confirmation, Megan Kanemba. Goal, Seychelles. Well, they just got to keep their heads up. 6 goals they conceded. Singapore, now the 5-0 down. losing the two games. It's a bit disheartening, but they've got to just keep the fight about them, Seychelles. I know it's difficult. As Papua New Guinea now comes surging forward once again. And, well, that was great across. He's looking up for Zale. The captain Gabo. Lovely ball through there. Opened up a body. Lovely cross there, looking for Saguda Zale, the substitute. Came on for Gossi. Now, Seychelles, can they pull something here from distance? Strips the keeper. But what about it? Was onto that. She did score from a similar position, Natasha Bibi. Frustration there, she did well. That's Papua New Guinea now surge forward. Pace too much here. It's got bodies and it's a square. And, well, oh, how did that stay out? I'm not too sure, but it's got the upright and somehow Seychelles survived that. Well, really not sure how that stayed out, but it's a good save though from Marie initially. Ball across as well, and Kaipu just laid it on nicely to Kudemba, who would have gotten her brace. Not sure how she missed that, and well, that's landed nicely, and to the relief of Murray.
Substitution for Seychelles.
So another substitution
the
being made
Arena by
Seychelles.
Replaced by number 23, the 14, Tara Bernardi, replaced by number 2, Jahira Harrison. Number 21, Sherry Jennifer, is replaced by number 10, Vesna Caesar. Double substitution for Papua New Guinea, number 6, Yvonne Gabon is being replaced by number 15, Kesai Katone. Number 12, Megan Gonemba is being replaced by number 13, Ramona Padio.
Two subs. Being made for Seychelles as well. Tara Larande coming out, and in her place will be Jahida Harrison. So Ginobo has come out for another good opportunity for Papua New Guinea. There you go, it's confirmation. The substitutions. Replay of this slip there. Just a minor right ankle. See another substitution. Well, just to recap the goals, 5-0 was Rachel Kadu opened the goal scoring. It was an own goal that saw Seychelles go one behind. A lovely ball through, it's onside as well. Good save, Mandy Gabriel. Might have just come off the post, actually, the crossbar. Yes, it has. I thought it initially looked like a save from Mandy Gabriel. Papua New Guinea. Safely into the arms of Mandy. She's pushing the players up and wanting to drop deeper into the opponent's half. Harrison just couldn't possession. Will be a foul. Forward here and was well intercepted that time. Read it well. This looks promising now from Seychelles. Can they just dig deep and just get that one goal just to give them a bit of confidence? Something to be proud of. Two goals in the first game against Singapore. Two goals from Natasha Bibi. Had two from the back of the net today. Really had a striking goal, but here they come again, Papua New Guinea. Is this going to be the sixth? And well, a great section once again from Attacker. She's been relentless at the back, time and time again. She's saved them numerous times. Vicious attempt from that angle, but just take a look at this speed and the pace of attacking, just coming in perfectly, timing that tackle. And well, it would have been interesting to see Haku had gone down. Might have just been a penalty there, but look at the pace here and time the tackle so well. And credit to Haku, she stayed on her feet as well. She could have easily gone down and well, got a penalty for that. Come on. earlier, ranked 49 in the world out of 170. Much better than the men's side as well. So they have played Singapore before, as they look to play them in the next match, the final match, and they come forward once again. Wave after wave of attack here from Papua New Guinea. They have played Singapore very different results in both fixtures. That was in 2015, more than 7 years ago, on the 4th and 6th of March. First one ended goalless, and the second ending 5-0 in favour of Papua New Guinea. So it'll be interesting to see how both teams fare against each other. Have some dangerous players, as we've seen. Kaifu, one of them. It's not FIFA accredited. This match as well as Papua New Guinea's the 2022 OFC Women's Nations Cup, and well, is this the 6? Yes, it is. Seychelles have been hit for 6 after 69 minutes. And big celebrations all round with this one. And a big smile as well from the number 16, 17-year-old, youngest player in the team. Sekude Zale has put aside 6-0 up against Seychelles.
Goal for Papua New Guinea scored by number 16, Sekude Zale.
And lovely finish. Good first touch, and she was so composed, you can see that. Good first touch, and just laid it on nicely and looked up and placed it perfectly. And what a big smile from the youngster, the 17-year-old Sekude Zale. Putting the 6th goal past her opponents on the 70th minute. And, well, I feel we might see a few more goals. Key now for Seychelles is to maybe try to just keep it under double digits. Have conceded now as many goals as they have against Singapore. The difference being they did score 2 against the hosts. Patio, 72 minutes. Seychelles just have to keep keep the concentration. They look like a tired side now. Josh Beebe, you can see at the top of your screens there, just shrug of the shoulders as they lose the ball once again. And they look to surge forward. Cross comes in, and is this going to be the eight? No, the crossbar keeps it out. They kept Papua New Guinea at bay, Seychelles, beg your pardon. But, well, 50 minutes, I've seen 7 goals.
Substitution for Seychelles, number 8, Rachel Kellen's been replaced by number 11, Florence Murray.
Coming in, well, believe it or not, the defender is a 41-year-old. As well to win the header, takes a shot, it's deflected. Seychelles survive another scare here. It's just been wave after wave of attack. They have not had a shot on target. Tasha Bibi is really running out of ideas and frustrated. 37-year-old. Lovely chip here. Onside. Can she get the goal? No, she does not. Flag was raised. Miles offside that time. High leg as well. It's a foul. This is the one where Rosbart saving. Seychelles. So the question is, are we going to see more goals? About 15 minutes left here at the Jalan Besar Stadium for the FAS Women's Tri Nations Series. Almost finding Natasha Bibi that time. Good ball through here, and this looks like this could be number 8, but who else is there to stop the attack? Once again, is that to ticket, who time again has saved Seychelles from, well, would have been clearly double digits by now. Very, very well timed challenge that time. And she's gone down as well. So, last thing to do is to lose her. AC. That was
of it.
Substitution for Papa Navini, number 4, Lucy Maimo, is being replaced by number 5, Shalom Wida.
So Lucy Maimo coming off for Shalom Wida. Did his substitution. So we'll have about 10 minutes left here. Remember, Monday is the big match between Singapore and Papua New Guinea, so do make your way down here to the Jalan Besar Stadium for what will be, I'm sure, an enthralling encounter between the two sides. Seeding 7 against Papua New Guinea, 6 against Singapore. Celine Chua will have to go back to the drawing board and some answers. Shells. This time up in with that timely challenge. So it will be Patio. The goal on the 75th minute. She will step up to take this penalty. And put Papua New Guinea's 8th goal on the scoreboard. And Gabriel looking to keep this out, and it's slotted calmly at the back of the net for Papua New Guinea's 8th goal. And well, in a hurry to pick it up, but four goals, that's a good positive. Number 13, Ramona Bettina Padio, who gets a second goal. And another substitution, it is Mari Kaipu comes off for Sonia Mhabe.
Substitution for Papua New Guinea, number 9, Mari Kaipu, is replaced by number 19, Sonia Mhabe.
Two goals if they do want to go into the double digits. Well, it's a good ball in here. Tasha Bibi, she chasing down, but she's offside. Puzzled Angeline Chua there. Very much offside. Well, here they come again, Papua New Guinea. And this time, the Gabriel pulls it with relief. Well, it's been a cold fest here at the Jalan Besar Stadium today. It's all been one-way traffic. It's all been Papua New Guinea. We've seen some good football as well. One of the players, me incidentally, is for Seychelles. She's actually kept Papua New Guinea pay numerous times with some clinical challenges. Anisha, second 19-year-old, impressed me the most here, despite being on the losing side. So we'll be disappointed. We can take resolve on the fact they did get two against Singapore, but here they come again, Papua New Guinea. Wahe is going for the nine, then she gets it. Nine goals for Papua New Guinea. Smiles around as they wait for the 10th goal. Lovely run through. Did so well to get
around. Your player from the Guinea scored goal number 19, Sonia and Harvey.
Sonia and Harvey. Student coming on. Has allowed her opponent to get the ninth goal. Well, are we going to see the 10th goal? Are we going to see the double digits? That's the question. There you go, observation, Sonia and Habe. Next aim is just to prevent New Guinea from reaching double figures. Just to let you know, remember, you can come down on Monday. It is Papua New Guinea versus Singapore, and that's going to be a trolling encounter between the two sides, I'm sure. with 15 goals collectively against Seychelles. Be a much tighter affair between the two. To the 90 minutes. I'm sure we'll see a couple of minutes of injury time as well with the likes of both sides, especially Seychelles, to bring in the medic a couple of times. The players are sustaining injuries as well. Seychelles in the second half. It's good to touch a BB there. In the hard yards, even at the end. 37-year-old. Strong for their opponents today. They are going to see the 10th goal. This is the one they're going for. And two in a corner as well as the clock trickles down to the 90th minute now.
Ladies and gentlemen, there will be 2 minutes of added time.
So 2 minutes of added time in the corner now for Papua New Guinea as they go for their 10th goal, and it's bouncing across. Six-head box. There's a whistle to the relief of Seychelles as they survive the double-figure trouncing. Straight to the arms of Mandy Gabriel that time. They've got about 30 seconds to fend this off. Seychelles. Just have to keep possession and it's the goal at hand. Pass in hand, but here it's a chance for them. Can they get their consolation? Touch BB goes down, gets the free kick. They're throwing as many bodies. They've got a yellow card as well, the first one of the match. So, will they just try and pick up the consolation goal here? Really throwing many bodies up front. Yes, she does. It is full time here at the Jalan Besar Stadium, and Seychelles survive a double.
And it's full time. The game finishes Seychelles 0, Papua New Guinea 9.
Singapore on the Monday. That is this, the confirmation of the scoreline. Papua New Guinea 9, Seychelles 0. And well, the final of these three matches will be played on Monday. And so joy all round for the ladies. And this is the goal scorers, of course, first half saw Richard Tadeu's own goal. Gunamba, he's got in on the 56, and then we saw Skuna Zali on the 70th, and then Mario on the 72nd and 82nd from a penalty spot for finally Sonia Pave rounding off the 9-goal trouncing of Seychelles on the 86th minute. Thanks a lot for joining us here at the Jalan Besar Stadium in the Tri Nation Series, Women's Tri Nation Series between Seychelles and Papua New Guinea. Final score is Seychelles 0, Papua New Guinea 9.